Hi, I'm Charlene Caralasia. I'm the Executive Director of Meriden Wallingford Chrysalis. Today I'm here with Carlton Smith, the Director of the Real Strength Project. So Real Strength is a new project to help eliminate violence in our communities. And it's a great complement in addition to what we do. But it's also important for us to just remind folks that Chrysalis provides services for victims and survivors of domestic violence, and that if folks need help, to please call. We provide 24-hour hotline services as well as shelter transitional living, but many folks who may need help may not need shelter, and you can come and reach out for help as well. We just had a couple amazing conversations with some folks that we've been working with, and over about 3 years, I'm just amazed when I think of where they came from when they started with us and how much they've grown, how much freedom they've found, how many smiles are in the kids' faces, and how much they've truly taken in about what Chrysalis is supposed to be all about, finding our strength and our freedom.
Right.
So I'm blown away.
It was truly amazing just hearing the kids first, the experiences that they had at shelter.
Well, that's my opinion.
My opinion is it is fun because we go on field trips and all stuff. And my mom liked it there. We all liked it there because we made a bunch of adult friends. Most adult friends and kids.
And yes, most adults for me.
We still go to school, but that's what I like still.
Jonathan, you also had a couple of guys that you got to work with that were your advocates. How was that for you? Evan and
Neil. When I had hard times, we used to talk through it.
You all had a girls group, too.
Yes, with Miss Anisha and
Miss Lindsay. It was special because we made tie-dye shirts, and I really liked it. My mom still has them. It's when I was 10. Right now, I'm 12.
It's just reaffirming that, you know, you're working with great people, because they felt that they made more relationships with the adult staff than they did with, you know, the other kids that were there. They have more adult friends now than kid friends. And it was just amazing that, you know, that Chrysalis was able to be there as a resource, as a place where someone can come in or a family can come in and find their footing in a way and, you know, escape, you know, situations. What the kids said, I believe they said, when you're up or down, when you're having your ups and downs, Chrysalis is a great place to be. And you felt that in their conversation, and it was sincere, and you know, they were glowing. They were glowing the whole time, and you know, they had a positive experience there.
Now, you both said before that there were some tough times.
Yes.
Yeah, we had our ups and downs, but we got through.
Yeah.
When my mom, when we couldn't buy no food, it was hard because my mom didn't have no more money, and we needed help, and we needed help with a lot of things, but we kept going whatever we had.
My life is safe. Thanks, Chrysalis is wonderful.
Shelter life can probably be scary at that age, you know. You coming in, not knowing, you know, strangers, and being a kid and going to school and being in kind of like your life turned upside down. But the kids seem like the Chrysalis staff, the residents kind of welcomed them up with open arms, and, you know, you felt the love coming through.
A lot of people, when they think about a shelter, that scares them. What would you tell them about being scared?
It's not really scary. They help you and they give you actually things that you need.
It was really fun to be in the shelter.
Because there was a playground there. We got to play there. And you guys give us presents for Christmas, or we did trick-or-treating and all this stuff. And for our birthdays, you guys give us something. And it's really awesome. I really enjoyed being in the shelter.
I love, too, that in their story now, there's no shame. They're able to talk about where they came from, how hard it was, and being homeless and a large family, and talking about all the progress that they've made, learning a new language, getting a U visa, driver's license, employment, you know, to being on their own. And they're able to talk about it with no shame.
I say every people's maybe know have a home. Go Chrysalis. It's my home, second Chrysalis. Chrysalis, my home. My ex-husband is work and sometimes drink. My life is so bad. And then my kids is same thing. And then maybe too much explain for me, not too much English. And then no explain too much, but my life is very bad. And Chrysalis saved me 3 years. Chrysalis. Give my kids clothes, give my kids pencils, give my kids shampoos, and give everything. Give friends, and Chrysalis give hugs and everything. And no say you black or you white or you Indian or you whatever one is open the door, coming and help.
And I think one of the wishes that I would have would be that anyone who's hearing this would know that violence is not their fault and is nothing to be ashamed of, and it's okay to ask for help. That took a lot of courage for her to make that call.
Right.
No, too much English is a little bit. Thank you, say go to school. And thank you, say go to school. But I say, have my daughter. And say, no problem. Maybe somebody help. Yeah, somebody help my take my daughter, little daughter, the 3 months, and go to school, and then little bit English. Thank you. No, and thank you, and having my visa. Thank you, having my kids safe. Thank you, me as the person strong. No say, oh, the guys say, oh, you love, and okay, yeah, me love, no? No, now no. I say no, my kids is first. And my life is first. Thank you. The somebody no have a home, or somebody is the husband is very mad, or the husband is maybe some have 2 or 3 kids, and say no, who pay the rent, who pay the electric, and come and drink and come and smoke, and again, never see have people's head. Yeah.
Wow.
Thank you, Michelle.
Thank you.
The mom was so impressive as well, you know, being able to overcome so many obstacles, language barrier, being a survivor, and you know, just having a load of a mother, a single mom, and it's just truly impressive what she's come through, and you can see it in her face as well. You know, Chrysalis helped her so much. She loves Chrysalis, and I know the language barrier was there. If she could speak English better, she would probably be talking now. But you know, she was glowing, and you could see that. And it was very, I don't even know how she did it. You know, it was just incredible staff, resources, but her, like you said, she was the reason that she was able to overcome these things. And Chrysalis was just just there as for an assist.
I love the sports metaphor. But it's a good metaphor too, because you are starting this new project, Real Strength. We're having a lot of fun trying to get our own footing, right, with this new project.
Right.
But as I was talking with the kids about their ups and downs and what they would want to share with other kids who may be struggling, the big thing they said was, if something's bothering you, tell someone.
If you think something's scary or anything, you should say something, not just keep it away from your parents and don't say anything, because then you won't, then you'll it just like
you'll get stuck in the rest of your life.
Yeah, and it will like some people say, haunt you.
And that's one of the cornerstones of your project.
Correct. We are working on helping men become better leaders, enhancing their leadership skills in an effort to end violence against women. And being an active bystander is one of the key pillars that we have for Real Strength. And being an active bystander means that we don't stay in neutral when we see something happening. We want to be able to intervene in a way which is safe for the bystander, but also we want to give an opportunity for individuals who are in a violent situation a chance to maybe be able to escape that situation, or maybe we can do something about it as far as just picking up the phone and calling the police. Being an active bystander means, you know, taking action in a safe and convenient way.
One of the things that I love about that, which I know we've talked about before, is the idea of families like Esther's not needing us at all, because the violence didn't happen, the hurt didn't happen. There's not lives that need to be saved.
Thanks, Miss, for saving my life and my kids. Thank you so much. I love Chrysalis.